You know, we don't win cases, we don't lose cases. At the end of the day, all we look to is to see that justice is served. I think that justice was well served today. At the end of the day, this case came down to a single issue, really. Because Mr. Ader had admitted that he had acted as the negotiator for the hostage takers in Somalia, the real issue was whether he had acted under duress or whether he had acted voluntarily. And Justice Smith, in a very lengthy decision, completely rejected Mr. Ader's story that he had acted under duress. So he's been convicted. It's been put over to early January to set a date for sentencing, and we'll take it from there. All of the Crown witness testimony was important evidence. The intercepted communications of Mr. Ader talking to Amanda's mother, Lorinda, was very important. But his admissions to the undercover officer were critical. As you heard, Justice Smith relied heavily on those admissions in rejecting Mr. Ader's story as completely unbelievable. I would say that it sends a message that if you take a Canadian citizen hostage in another country, you're not safe. That if we can, if the law enforcement here can find you and can do an investigation, we're going to pursue that.